हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट लैंग्वेज आइडेंटिटी। सबसे पहले पढ़ेंगे व्हाट इज आइडेंटिटी। आइडेंटिटी होती क्या है? द वर्ड आइडेंटिटी इज ऑफन यूज्ड बट इट इज नॉट इजी टू डिफाइन। द मीनिंग एट्रीब्यूट टू इट ऑल्सो चेंजेस थ्रू आउट टाइम। इन द 19th सेंचुरी अ फेयरली स्टैटिक आइडिया ऑफ National identity was preferred very recently with growing globalization. Large group of people are on the move and the link between place and identity has become less evident. People are increasingly confronted with other cultures. They would also affiliate themselves more consciously with certain aspects of their background. As it happens, they may define themselves on the basis of cultural differences with other groups. Therefore, language, religion can start to play a larger role than it had done in the place of origin. Today, a link is often assumed between language, origin, culture and identity, though the situation is far more complex because identity is not a static notion and cannot always be linked to culture and origin. People may also define their identities on the basis of language, religion, sexual preferences, politics, etc. Speakers of the same language do not necessarily share the same culture. Moreover, the aspects any person considers decisive for their identity may shift or change over time or when the person moves to another environment or culture. First, identity and language learning. A significant construct in language learning research is identity. Identity is defined as how a person understands his or her relationship to the world, how that relationship is structured across time and space, and how the person understands possibilities for the future. Recognizing language as a social practice, identity highlights how the language constructs and is constructed by a variety of relationships. Just because of the diverse position from which language learners can participate in social life, identity is theorized as multiple subject to change and a site of struggle. The diverse conditions under which language learners speak, read or write the second language are influenced by relations of power. In different sites, learners who may be marginalized in one site may be highly valued in another. It is for this reason every time language learners interact in the second language. Whether the oral or written mode, they are engaged in identity constructions and navigation. The structural conditions and social context are not entirely determined through human agency. Language learners who struggle to speak from one identity position may be able to reframe their relationship with their interlocutors and claim alternative, more powerful identities from which to speak, thereby enabling learning to take place. Next, language significant aspect of identity. Whether the language is a significant aspect of your identity depends partially on the status of the language. The reality is very complex, though the status of Language is important but not always. This is so because it is possible that the original language is partially disappearing, but it still plays an important symbolic role in a given ethnocultural group. Think of Wales. In Wales, for other groups, language may originally not have been a distinctive features at all. Just like the American Christian from Turkey, in Turkey, which is predominantly Muslim, they would define themselves first and foremost as Christians. When some of these groups moved to Brussels in the late 80s, they felt that this was not a distinctive feature among a majority of Christians. This is why language gradually did become an important marker of their identity. The former illustrates that the relationship between language and identity is not so straightforward and consistently subject to change. When people migrate, the constant interaction between different groups causes original group borders to fade and to shift. The son of a Portuguese migrant in Anderlecht may feel closer to his Brussels skateboarding friends than to other Portuguese, even though they share the same language. The language users can display their identities, but they cannot affect them in any way. Language used in identity are conceptualized rather differently. In a socio-cultural perspective on human action, the identity is not to be seen as singular, fixed, and intrinsic to the individual. Rather, it is viewed as socially constituted, a reflexive dynamic product of social, historical, political context of an individual's lived experiences. Next, social identity and language. When we use language, we do so as individuals with social histories. Our histories are defined in part by our membership in a range of social groups into which we are born, gender, social classes, religion, and race. The language and identity carry expectations built up over time through socialization into our own social groups about what we can do and cannot do as members of our groups. The linguistic resources we use to communicate and our interpretations of those used by others are shaped by these mutually held perceptions. In brief, we can say that who we are, who we think others are, and who other think we are meditate in important ways of our individual uses and evolutions of our linguistic actions in any communicative encounter. Therefore, we understand that the individuals use language to co-construct their everyday worlds, and in particular their own social roles and identities and those of others. The moreover aspects any person considers decisive for their identity may shift or change over time or when the person moves to another environment or a culture. The diverse condition under which Learners speak, read or write the second language, are influenced by reliefs or faults in different sides. Learners who may be marginalized in one side may be highly valued in other. When people migrate, the consistent interaction between different groups causes original groups, borders to fade and to shift. The son of a migrant in adolescence may feel closer to his Brussels skateboarding friends than to other, even though they share the same language. Region every time language learners interact in the second language, whether in the oral or written mode, they are engaged in identity constructions and negotiations, the structure, conditions and social context are not entirely determined. Through human agency, language learners who struggle to speak from one identity position may be able to reframe their relationship with their interlocutors and claim alternative. More powerful identities from which to speak, thereby enabling learning to take place. Recognizing language as a social practice, identity highlights how the language constructs and it is constructed by relationship. Thank you for watching.